Hey everyone, in this session we're going to talk about how to edit your audio in Adobe Premiere. When you're working on a video project, editing your audio is so crucial. You can't just rely on the visuals alone. Your audio needs to be crisp, clear, and with proper levels. We're going to show you how to do that today. So I have a sample project here in Adobe Premiere, just several clips of somebody speaking to the camera. Nice, easy way to get into this. As you know, when you put a clip on your timeline in Adobe Premiere, you have both a video and an audio portion. To take a closer look at your audio, we want to expand it. To expand it, you can double-click on the blank area within Audio Channel 1. When you double-click it, you can see the waveform. That's the visual representation of your audio. Now we're going to play our audio, and when you play it, you have an audio meter on the right-hand side that'll show you with green bars how loud your audio is. Let's take a look.
My name is Vivek Prithmani. I'm a resident here in New York, and I have an app called the Learn Bhangra app. It teaches you a dance form called Bhangra. It's a high-energy dance from the Punjab state of northern India and Pakistan.
So as you can see, as you play your clips, you can see it visually represented by those green bars in there. And these numbers represent the decibel levels where it's peaking at. So as we watch this back, we can see that it's about at negative 15, negative 12, where the peaks are occurring. Now those peaks are the highest point in that audio clip, the loudest point where somebody gets really excited for a moment and says something super loud. The yellow lines represent the peak point on there. The green is generally the audio level coming out of your clip. So this is pretty good, but it's a little low. Notice the green is generally around like negative 15, negative 18. It's peaking at about negative 12. We want your dialogue to peak at about negative 4 generally to get good, consistent audio. So here's a few ways you can edit your audio. First off, when you click on your audio clip and hover over the middle, you'll see that there is a little rubber band here in the middle, and you can click and drag that up and down. And notice that those decibel levels are changing. So you can make it really, really loud, or you can take it all the way down to nothing and have it silent. So if you make it loud, you'll see those levels start to change over there in your audio meter. Let's take a look.
My name is Lavesh Prithmani. I'm a resident here in New York, and I have an app called the Learn Bhangra app.
So it's peaking a little bit better, but it's a little bit too loud. We're getting a lot of that background noise there, which we don't really want. There's a few things you can do for that, though. So you can drag that up and down and change your audio levels. A few other things you can do are set keyframes on your audio clip. So what you're going to do is take your blue cursor and set it where you want in your clip the keyframe to occur, and you're going to click the little Add Remove Keyframe button here. And notice that it adds a keyframe to your audio clip. You can then move over and set another keyframe. And what that does is it sets those anchor points on your audio. So if you drag this keyframe down, now we're telling the clip from this point, I want there to be a gradual lowering of the audio. And then we can set another keyframe a little bit later. And let's say we want the audio to rise dramatically from that point. So what these keyframes are telling us is that from this point, the audio levels are going to drop. From this point, the audio levels are going to rise. Here's what that sounds like.
My name is Lavesh Prithmani. I'm a resident here in New York, and I have an app called...
So notice how now it's starting to get much louder.
I do a dance form called Bhangra. It's a high-energy dance from the Punjab state of northern India and Pakistan.
So those audio levels are going up and down because you're telling it to lower and rise. So that's one way that you can adjust those little moments in your audio clip. If somebody's really, really quiet and you need just to bring that section up a little bit, you can do that. And if somebody's getting really, really loud, you can bring that down, which is okay. So you can set those keyframes to do that. I'm going to take these keyframes out for the moment. You can control click on them and hit delete, and that will get rid of those keyframes. So that's one way you can edit your audio. Here's another way that I like too. If you control click on a clip and go to audio gain, that opens up a menu for adjusting your audio levels. This is basically the menu version of doing what we just did. Instead of dragging that rubber band up and down, you can adjust your gain by a certain number of decibel levels. So if you want to increase it by 4 decibels, make it louder, you can do that. Or if you want to decrease it by 8 decibels, you can do that too. Just another way of doing that. What I like in here is the option to normalize all peaks. I'm going to show you what that is. To start off, we're going to get out of the menu, and we're going to highlight all of the audio clips. Now, because this is the same person speaking in each of these clips, we want it to sound pretty consistent. We don't want one clip to be really quiet and one clip to be really loud. So we're going to highlight all the clips, and we're going to go into the audio gain menu. So control click, hit audio gain. And we're going to normalize all peaks. What this does is it takes the loudest points in each of the clips, about here, maybe about here, right at the beginning of this one. I think the peak is somewhere right over here. It's going to take the loudest point in each of them and have it capped at a certain decibel level that you set. So we know that we want to normalize our audio, and we don't want the peaks to go any higher than about -4, -3. So I'm going to put -3. We're going to normalize all of our peaks too. I can hit OK. And notice all the waveforms suddenly got bigger. We've increased the audio levels of these clips so that the peaks are peaking at about that -3 level. So let's take a look back.
My name is Lavesh Prithmani. I'm a resident here in New York, and I have an app called the Learn Bhangra app. It teaches you a dance form called Bhangra. It's a high energy dance from the Punjab state of Northern India and Pakistan. Really, our goal is we want people to enjoy this dance form.
So notice how we're never peaking past this -3 right here. All of our audio levels are a little bit more consistent, and the peaks are all the same. We're not going to have one where someone is suddenly that much louder than somebody else. He's consistent through all of these four clips. That's a very easy way that you can normalize your audio. That's because you want to make sure that your audio is nice and consistent. And that goes with any other audio that you have in your project as well. So sometimes your projects are going to be more than just dialogue. You might have music or sound effects or something like that. So you want to make sure that everything is consistent there. So I'm going to take this music clip that I have and drag it down onto the Audio 2 channel. And we can tell right away that this is way too loud. Look at how big this waveform is compared to this. If we were to play this back, we're not going to be able to hear Lavesh at all. Whoa, way too much there. We don't want that. And you notice how we're starting to get into the red? That's because this audio is too loud. It's going up past zero. We don't want that. Again, you want your audio to be much lower. So this is where you have to pay close attention. Use your ears. Make sure that you're listening to it and that it sounds okay. Very easy way to do that is to go into the audio tab up at the top. When you click that, changes your layout, optimizes it for editing audio. Notice now that you have a mixer over here in this window. You have audio 1, which corresponds to this channel, audio 1, and audio 2, which corresponds to your music channel on audio 2. If your audio 2, your music, is too loud, just like pulling on that rubber band, you can take your volume control and bring it down. And this is more accurate than using the rubber band because you can get a precise number there. So we're going to take it down to like -19. And as we play this back.
My name is Lavesh Prithmani. I'm a resident here in New York.
It's a little bit easier to hear that audio now. Still a little too loud, so we're going to take that down to about -21.
It teaches you a dance form called Bhangra. It's a high energy dance.
Basically, what you're doing is saying you're not peaking past this point.
Really, our goal is we want people to enjoy this dance form. It's a free app. It's something, you know, I put my time and effort into just because I love teaching.
Now it's a little too quiet. I'm going
to
bring this up.
We want anybody to be able to explore it and to learn a little bit more about the culture that it comes from, which is the Punjabi culture. Yeah, it's been fun. We've been trying to take some popular artist songs and show some of our moves to them, you know.
So now we're taking that music and our dialogue and we're mixing it. We're making sure that everything sounds correct. So just like you normalized all the peaks on these clips, you can make sure that the audio level on your music doesn't clash with what you have. You can adjust it up and down using your audio meter here. So those are some easy tips for normalizing your audio. Again, make sure that everything sounds consistent. You've got your meters, you've got the different tools in Premiere. Ultimately, one of the best tools are your own ears. So make sure that it sounds good, make sure that it sounds clean and understandable, and your audio is going to be great for your projects.